Hello friends, today we'll learn design of animation sequence. This is part 1 of the animation in computer graphics series, so let's get started. So what are we going to learn today? Today we'll learn what are the steps of design of animation sequence. Okay, so there are 4 steps in designing any animation sequence. First one is called storyboard layout. Second one is called object definition. Third one is called keyframe specification. And fourth one is generation of in-between frames. Okay, so at the end of this, we will also take a look at an example of a small animation sequence that we create ourselves. Okay, so first one is called storyboard layout, first step. In storyboard layout, basically what happens is you write down what is the story, what happens in the animation, that is what are the objects that are present in the animation, then what kind of motion those objects go into. Okay, so basically you write down what happens in the animation, who is there in the animation. Okay, now second one is the object definition. Now object definition is given for each participant in the animation. Okay, so objects definition will have what kind of color the object has, what kind of shape the object has, okay, what motion the objects are going to do. For each object, the different motion we have to specify in the object definition itself. Okay, so third step is called keyframe specification. Now what are keyframes? Keyframes are detailed drawings, okay, detailed drawings of a scene of the animation at a particular moment. In each keyframe, what happens is an object, every object actually, is placed at an exact position according to the time frame at that moment. Okay, so keyframes specify where the object will be at what time. Okay, and that's why these keyframes are very important. Now keyframes were spaced out at short intervals so that we get a better animation sequence. Okay, so more the number of keyframes, the better looking animation will be done. So it also provides more information about the position of the object at specific times. Okay, so this is the third step, that is you provide the keyframe specification. Now fourth one, generation of in-between frames. Now what are in-between frames? In-between frames are frames that are in between the keyframes. Simple. Depending on the medium of the number of frames differ. Okay, so depending on the medium, the number of frames differ. For example, on the film there are 24 frames per second. Okay, on television generally we have 30 to 60 frames per second. So the number of in between frames also increase. Okay, so there are around 3 to 5 in between frames between 2 keyframes. Okay, so these are the 4 steps. Now we'll take a look at an example. So in the example, what happens is first we'll write the first step, that is storyboard layout. So we'll write down what happens in our animation. So let's say in our animation, one apple falls from the tree and it bounces to the ground. Then a bird flies in and swirls around to see if any danger is there. Then it sits on the apple, picks it up and flies away. So this is a simple example that we are going to create. So this is the storyboard layout, what happens in the animation. That is the sequence of events. Next one is object definition. So in our scene of animation, what happens is there is a tree. So we need a tree. We need an apple to fall down, correct? Then we need the mud on the ground so that the apple bounces off. Fourth one is a bird that flies in and picks up the apples and flies away. Okay, so these are the 4 objects that are present in our animation. Now these are the keyframes. Suppose we have a tree over here. Okay, we have a tree, there is mud, this is the apple. Next keyframe, the apple falls down and rolls to the ground. Next keyframe, the bird flies in. Next keyframe, the bird is swirling around in the air. Okay, like this. Yeah, now the bird flies down on the apple. Next keyframe, the bird flies away with the apple. So now we'll take a look at this animation, how it happens. So this is the apple on the tree. So it falls down first to the ground, it bounces off. Okay, now the bird comes in flying in. Then it swirls around in the air, again swirls around in the air. Then it sits on the apple, picks it up and flies away. So this was a very simple animation in which we use all the 4 steps to define and make the animation. That's it for today guys. If you like this video, share it with your friends. If you have any doubts, feel free to ask me in the comment section below. Subscribe to my channel if you want. Thank you very much.